Today, like many ranches in the Rupununi, Data Now is seeking to expand into the ecotourism sector, treating guests to ranch life as well as incredible journeys through the forests and savannas of the surrounding country.
Ecotourism is something we've been doing for the last few years. And we started basically knowing nothing about it and probably still have a lot to learn. But what we've been selling is actually our own experiences rather than trying to copy what other people have been doing. It's basically taking people and showing them something that they wouldn't see anywhere else, or they wouldn't see it in the way we would show it to them. The area is still relatively untouched. And a lot of places you go in fact are pristine. Nobody, relatively few people go there. People who go there just pass through. The stuff on the ranch is basically ranch life. Like come, take part in what's going on, ride on a roundup, go camping, go walking, go visit petroglyphs, ride, or set up routes like a rally or something. You know, from point A to point B, you camp, you keep on going. So there's, I try to see as much of the Rupununi as possible. And if we go into an area that is part of an Amerindian reservation, we would contact the, we'd make arrangement previously anyway with the village council and the captain and say what we want to do. And if they agree on it, which the two communities that we deal with have agreed to go ahead with it, we pay a head tax to everybody that comes in, and then we hire everybody from that community in the terms of guides, boatsmen, cooks, whatever. And we also try to encourage the community to set up facilities to, say, like, handle guests. Like, instead of us doing it, provide them food, set up a little guest house, and then they would stay there and they would get income from that, no? We had so many ups and downs here. It's, you know, we're always optimistic, but you get something, one hand is gone with the other. I have, you know, two visions that things are going to be good. They won't change much, but you'll be just getting more money, better standard of living and stuff like that. And then I have another kind of vision that what's going to happen with people that have money from other places, whether it's outside of Guyana or even within Guyana, are going to come up into this area or areas like this and take it over and use it as they like without any kind of regard for the people who live here, you know. And I think that's probably the more realistic view. Seems to be happening already. So I resent like big companies coming and taking out big blocks of land because it stops the local people from having access to those things. Like traditionally, Damarin people would go when they need money, or people from the Rupununi in general, they want a little money, they go and look for some gold somewhere, no? Find a couple of penny weights or ounces, they'd come back and sell it. And when these concessions are given out, the land, they can no longer do that in their land. Or they could be chased off it, they feel dispossessed. People been living there for centuries doing that, they feel they have a right, you know, and maybe they do have a right, at least if these companies do come in, they should have serious dialogue with the people who live in those communities as to how things will be done, if they will be done at all, and what they will get out of it now and in the future.
Traveling north reveals another type of Rupununi landscape with fewer rock formations and less green.
Thank you.
In the northern savannah is the smaller Karanambu Ranch. It was built by a famous Rupanuni pioneer named Tiny McTurk earlier in this century on a site said to be very unlucky by the local Amerindians. This prophecy turned out to be false, and Tiny's ranch prospered over the years. Today it is run by his daughter, Diane McTurk. Karanambu has about 600 head of cattle, but present economic conditions have made it necessary to seek alternative means of income. In the early 1980s, the ranch was set up to accommodate guests. Since then, Karanambu has become an important venue for ecotourism. Diane has adapted the ranch with facilities to host guests from around the world. They come for the pure relaxation of the area, as well as to fish and see the amazingly diverse flora, bird, and animal life. Recently, the family owners of Karanambu have established the Karanambu Trust in an effort to assure the continuation of environmentally sound development of the ranch's activities. The ranch, like Dadanawa, is located on the Rupanuni River. Also, as at Dadanawa, most of the workers are Amerindian. Here in the north, they are Mikushi Indians.
Yeah, that's better. Huh? Does he have a name?